Now that you're well-versed in animating constants, it's time to revisit the other constraint property we wanted to animate, the multiplier. This will require some new techniques. Animating multipliers is not as straightforward as animating constants. While simply changing the value of the constant works perfectly, you cannot take the same approach with multipliers. This is due to multiplier status as a get-only property. So how do you change the multiplier?
You actually have to replace the entire constraint. There are a few ways you can choose to tackle this depending on your project's needs or your own preferences. In this exercise, we'll use the following approach. Use the constraints property on a view to find the constraint we want to animate, remove that constraint, and finally, replace it with a new constraint that uses a different multiplier. Once you've done this, animating the multiplier change is actually exactly the same. If you force the layout to update from within the animation's closure, any layout changes will be animated. With that, let's return to our packing list app. This time, we're going to animate the title label so that when the menu is open, the title scoots to the left and sits a little higher up than it does now. To start, we need to figure out which constraints control the title label's X and Y position. That's where the constraints property I mentioned comes in. This magical view property contains every constraint held by a view.
What does that mean, held by the view?
Per Apple's own documentation, constraints are held by the closest view that contains both items in the constraint. Constraints that are held by a view don't constitute an exhaustive list of constraints that affect a view, however. You can see this illustrated in Interface Builder. Every constraint that affects a view is listed in the Size Inspector. Constraints that a view holds are listed on the left in the document outline. A constraint between a subview and its superview is held by the superview, like this constraint between the title label and menu view, which is held by menu view. A constraint between two subviews is held by the superview of both, like this constraint between the button and the title label, also held by menu view.
That means that if we want to programmatically search for a constraint, we first need to think about what view would hold that constraint. We've just seen in Interface Builder that the constraints affecting the title label's X and Y center position are held by menu view, which is title label's superview. Let's try iterating through all of the constraints held by that superview near the top of toggle menu under the call to layout if needed.
Build and run. Click the plus button. Then open the debugger with Shift Command Y if it isn't open already. There are all five constraints held by the menu view.
Now let's narrow the search for a constraint based on some of its properties. Use an if statement to find a constraint where the first item is the title label and the first attribute is title label's center X property.
Once you've found a matching constraint, you already know how to make one kind of change to it. Animate the constant for this constraint you fished out with a ternary operator. The layout is already being updated within this animation below, so the title label should shimmy to the left when the menu is open.
Build and run to make sure that worked.
Voila! But that seems a cumbersome way to find a constraint. Let's try an easier way to find, say, the constraint that centers the title label vertically in its superview.
There is a way to select a specific constraint other than storing it. It's easily illustratable from Interface Builder and does not involve IB outlets. Open main.storyboard and find the title label. In the Size Inspector, select the constraint that says Align Center Y to Superview.
Aha! We can effectively name a constraint with the identifier property. Call this one Title Center Y. While this method isn't as direct as making IB outlets for constraints, it is more straightforward to search for the identifier of a constraint than an assortment of other miscellaneous attributes.
Now let's do something with this constraint back in viewcontroller.swift. Below our first constraint search party, start another one, this time checking for the constraint with the title center Y identifier. If you take a look at the app with the menu open, the title label is feeling a little close to that horizontal slider. You can animate the multiplier to bring the label up slightly when the menu is open.
Now that we've found the constraint we want to animate, we're ready for the next step: remove the original constraint. If you deactivate a constraint like this and don't hold a reference to it, it will be deleted from memory the next time the layout is updated.
In this case, that's exactly what we want. You're going to create something like a constraint phoenix. Each time the menu button is tapped, the constraint will be destroyed, and a new constraint with the same name will rise from its ashes.
Exactly. The final step is to create a new constraint that matches the original constraint in every way, except for the multiplier. Use this monster of an initializer.
The first item is title label, the attribute is center Y, related by is equal. The second item is title label superview, again with a center Y attribute. For the multiplier, use a ternary operator to set it to either 0.67 or 1. And finally, set the constant to 0.
To sum that up, this constraint says that the title label's vertical center position should be equal to 67% or 100% of its superview's vertical center, with a constant offset of 0.
With that multiplier dependent upon whether the menu is open, yes. To finish this off, you still need to set the identifier for the constraint so that it can be found and destroyed the next time the button is tapped.
Set the priority to default high instead of the default assigned priority of required. And, of course, you need to activate it.
Build and run.
Hey, this is starting to look pretty nice.
If you like this collection of videos on core animation, just search our back library. We have a ton more on our YouTube channel. And if there's something you'd like to see, definitely let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching.